Hi guys, welcome to Saute at Sight.
Like and subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon for latest updates and recipes.
So to prepare the crab curry East Indian style, you will need 1 teaspoon of cumin seeds, 3 cloves, 5 peppercorns, 5 garlic cloves, 1/2 inch ginger, 1 big onion sliced, and 3 green chilies. Apart from that, you will require a half or almost 3/4 cup grated coconut, a ball of tamarind soaked in water, and apart from that, you will need some bottle masala. That is, you can take about 1 teaspoon of bottle masala and 1 tablespoon of coriander powder. So to prepare the curry, first we will be dry roasting the masalas and then grinding it. I'll take the pan and heat it. Pour in some oil. Once the oil is heated, I'll proceed to add the cumin, the cloves, and the peppercorn, the garlic, you don't need to finely chop the garlic because it's just for the roasting and we'll finally grind the garlic, so no need of finely chopping anything. The ginger, and give it a quick stir. To this I'll be adding 3/4 of the chopped onion, and rest I'll be using when I'm making the curry. You can add to this. I'll keep some chilies and the onions for sauteing it later when preparing the curry. This is a very simple and easy crab curry recipe, and the main ingredient, that is the bottle masala, which is the specialty of East Indians. So I absolutely love this curry. I'll saute the onions and the garlic and ginger and the rest of the spices until the onions are not golden brown. The onions are turning golden brown, and also the ginger and garlic is almost done. Now I'll proceed to add in the scraped coconut. So if you have dry coconut, that would be a better option, but in case if you don't have, then you can use the normal fresh coconut. So because the dry coconut gives you a better taste. So while the coconut and onions and the rest of the spices are getting roasted, I'll proceed to add in 1 tablespoon of coriander powder. I'll mix this well. To know that the masalas are properly roasted, it should be very dry in texture, and also it should be a little brownish, but not completely brown. You don't need to burn it, just a little texture of brown and a little dryness in the masala. As you can see that the masalas are nicely roasted and it's turned like goldenish brown, and now I'll proceed to room it off heat, let it cool down, and then grind it with some water to get a very fine paste. So I put the spices in the jar, and now I'll add in some water, not much, and proceed to grind it to a fine paste. My masala is now done, and now I proceed to prepare the curry. So to prepare the curry, I'll take the same pan. You don't need another individual pan, you can use the same one. And let's pour in some oil. I'll heat the oil, and then I'll proceed to add in the chopped onion and green chili that I left aside before. I'll saute this well. Once the onions are turned golden brown, I'll proceed to add in the ground masala paste. I'll saute the masala. So as the masala is getting roasted, I will now proceed to add in the main ingredient of this dish, is the bottle masala. I'll take about 1 teaspoon of bottle masala. You can add as per your taste, but don't add too much because this has too many masalas, so you don't want to end up spoiling the dish. I believe that the bottle masala is a self-sufficient masala and you don't need anything else to add flavor to your dish. Just little ingredients, the bottle masala, and your dish is done. I'll add in some turmeric as well, just half a teaspoon for the color. Now I'll add in some tamarind pulp. Stir it well. Now I'll add in some more water. You can alter the water as per the thickness you require for your curry. So for this curry, I've taken about 4 crabs. So this would do good for 4 to 5 crabs, small ones. And if it is more than that, you need to alter, you know, the quantity of the masalas. And you need to follow the same steps. So you can alter accordingly. I'll add in some salt as per taste. And then add in my crabs. I'll stir the crabs into the curry. Just be careful that you don't break the crabs. I'll let this cook for about 10 minutes with the lid covered. And the crabs are then done. So it's already past 10 minutes and my crab curry is now done and ready to be ravished. So I hope you'll enjoy watching the video, guys. Please do like and subscribe to our channel. You can also follow us on Facebook, Instagram and Twitter at SauteedSite and show us your love. And you can log into our website www.curioushomechefs.com for latest updates and recipes. So see you next time, guys.